Yes, the food stock is there. It cannot be freely distributed. That everybody must work and they get some remuneration. And that is why they are getting, government of India is giving 23 rupees subsidy. And state governments are giving, some state governments are giving 3 rupees, 5 rupees. And they are giving, some state giving free of cost and some state are giving at 1 rupee.
Well, Mr. Reddy is calling
that
in.
That is a different thing.
Mr. Reddy is watching the news hour in Belgium. He is calling in from Belgium. Mr. Reddy. Good afternoon. You're watching in Belgium. I presume it's still, afternoon there. Good afternoon. And who's your question to?
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Arnab Goswami. I admire that. Actually, I want to ask the Congress person, really, it's very pity that, the rupee has gone down so much. And I would like to ask him, for example, if I have the money, I can give it. If there is no money, then how can they give it? They have to compromise on other things. So there is no development. It will be seizing. So
I don't think we have reached to that point. I don't think the nation has not reached to that point to meet this additional expenditure of 40,000 crores. And the nation is not going to fall down. The budget, with a budget of 16,65,000 crore, I don't think this is
a new bottle.
And why you are saying like this?
They are fooling the people. Then they are fooling the people. They are not giving them anything new. That means the old budget only they are repackaging.
Restore,
adding a little corruption to it. And making it old wine in a new bottle.
No, I think
that's what Bhakta Charan Das just
said. No, I know, brother. PUC, your party is not involved in corruption, I know.
You know that. Thank you for acknowledging it. We don't do the scams. The way the Congress has done, we ran a good government for six years, but there was no scam in our government. One government fell like anything,
and you still think that you are proud of. Wow.
Mr. Bhakta Charan Das, what kind of argument?
The nation has watched your state government and your NDA government.
No, Mr. Bhakta Charan Das, what kind of argument is this? I'm beginning to get increasingly concerned. You do scams, I do scams. You're corrupt. I'm corrupt. You lose files. No. Your files are missing. Your Colgate files are missing. My Colgate files are missing. You messed it up. I'll mess it up. I don't think messing up the economy is the right of a political class. Sir, read any newspaper today in the world, and what are they telling you? There are less and less reasons for people to invest in India. Please think about it, Mr. Bhakta Charan Das. Restore.
That is the situation the BJP has started deliberately.
Whatever.
To destabilize the whatever. In the last 2 years.
Whatever. Your political fight is your political fight. I should not suffer. The people of the country cannot suffer because you're fighting. You can't push your reform bills.
We are not fighting. We are raising the people's voice against corruption.
Sir, the country's economy is sinking.
People of the nation are part and parcel of the system.
Yes, and the people of the...
They are involved in the system.
Yes, and that's why they are asking you today. Restore the system to health. Pawan Verma, this is a very disturbing line of argument we are seeing today. But I think the phone calls also reflect something. All the phone calls today have been extremely cynical of the food security bill. Now, the Congress can say this is a urban... viewer of Newsa who doesn't quite matter, who's not our vote bank, but Mr. Bhakta Charan Das, they too are citizens of this country. They too have a voice.
Just two points, Arnab.
I never said
two
that.
Points, Arnab,
every citizen, he may be urban or rural, they have got their say. I am not ignoring their say.
Arnab, just 2 points quickly. I began this debate by saying that beyond this kind of political acrimony where, as you yourself put it, you did this wrong, I did this wrong, I think this entire discussion should focus on the fact that has the functioning of democracy become antithetical to the imperatives of governance? Because there is no point name-calling endlessly. The entire economy, if it grows at 5%, there's already been a contraction of 20% in the job market. The second point is that this polarity between middle class and those below it cannot be sustained beyond a point. If 30% of India remains hungry today, it's an illusion that the middle class can create an island for itself to prosper. Except in fantasy, you can't build a first floor without a foundation. So there is a holistic need to relook at governance and deliveries where economy is concerned.
I also worry tomorrow that if there is great volatility in the global markets, you know, the government keeps saying, Rashid Kidwai, that this volatility in global markets because of global factors, our economy is going down. Tomorrow, God forbid, if there is a bad monsoon, for example. I'm just saying this out. I'm not some hardcore critic of the food bill as Prasenjit makes me out to be. All I'm saying is if there is a bad monsoon and we have to import food grains, if there is that kind of a situation, what impact will that have on the economy? Have we factored all this in? Rashid Kidwai, is the government still determined to push it through come what may?
Yes, sir, that is what I am trying to explain. Mr. Bhaktacharan Das is not saying a lot of things which he should have been saying. See, this was not an easy decision for Congress party to take. There were a lot of deliberations within Congress, within UPA, and then they arrived at it because they are desperate. Their image is very bad. There is a crisis of confidence. There are all sorts of problems that this government is facing. Now, they are desperate to win because, unfortunately, in politics, the only way is criteria is victory, and that is what would take them forward. So they have come to this conclusion. Sonia Gandhi is taking a huge gamble. She doesn't like to take gambles, but this time she is doing that. And but what baffles me most is why is, you know, Samajwadi Party, BSP, BJP, all other parties which are not really stakeholders, why are they supporting such a bad piece of legislation?
Well, I think BJP is caught in a bind, you see, because they don't want to support the bill, but they can't be seen opposing the bill. They don't want to support the bill, but they can't be seen.
The right questions before the government. We are asking the government to respond. If poverty has come down, why the number of beneficiaries is 81 crores? They have asked the question, if 165 grams gives 500 calories to a person, how are you actually giving him food security? And for the balance, at what price, as you rightly pointed out, imported grains, at what price will they have to procure?
The question only is this, as one of the viewers put it today, if a person wants to help somebody else by transfusing blood, the first thing you do is check whether the person is healthy. If a person is himself injured, you don't transfuse blood from an injured or diseased person into another person. And I think that's the big challenge. That's what one of our NewsHour viewers has written to me. That the big challenge is that the Indian economy today is injured. And to be expecting an injured Indian economy, you know, to be bleeding itself more, I don't know whether it's the right thing. And I put this question with all earnestness to all NewsHour viewers. Do you think this is the right time to be pushing this bill? I'd like to hear from you. Thank you to each and every one of our panelists for joining me on debate number 2 on the NewsHour tonight.